Hello, Conway school kids. Meteorologist Kevin Skorupa in the Storm Watch 9 Weather Center at WMUR-TV in Manchester. I am sorry we can't be there in person for your career day, but wanted to just give you kind of a thumbnail sketch of what it is like to be a meteorologist. I'll show you a couple of different things that we search at and look at most days, just kind of a day in the life. My day starts at probably 1:30 in the morning when the alarm goes off. That is probably the toughest part of my job. And when I come into work, I'm looking at probably about 200 different weather maps to try to figure out what the weather is going to do. So let me show you a few of the different computers that I use to try to figure out the weather on a daily basis. And then I'll answer any possible questions you might have about the weather. So 6 different computers in the weather office. The first one makes the maps you see on TV. Every one of these little boxes you see on the left is a different weather symbol. And we're able to make about 20 maps in 20 minutes every single morning. The second computer is just sitting there waiting for warnings from the National Weather Service. That is the computer that if you're watching Channel 9, it will set off an alarm that will alert you to the screen to show you information about where the warning is. Third computer ingests all the maps we get, satellite images, temperature maps, and updates them for me. So when I'm on live TV with my handy little clicker and I go to a temperature map, it has updated all those maps for me. Fourth computer is the one that I use every morning to try to figure out what the weather is going to do. There are 9 different sets of maps from all over the world. These are run through math equations to try to figure out what the weather is going to do. The trick is, if they're all different, they're not all going to wind up being right. So in the end, I have to try to figure out which maps look best and hopefully choose the correct ones. The other two computers you see on live TV, this is the one that sets up the maps that you see in the order that you see them on television. And the final one sounds like something from Star Wars. It is a radar where there is an invisible beam sent up through the sky in 50 different locations across the country. Closest one to you is just north of Portland, Maine. By the time it gets to you, it's about a half mile up in the sky, and that invisible beam is looking for anything falling through it made of water. When it finds it, it sends the beam back to the radar and makes the map of the big green, orange, and yellow blobs that tells us where it's raining, how heavy it is, and how fast it's moving. Clouds tell us a lot about what the weather's doing. There are 3 basic types of clouds. These cumulus clouds usually mean nice weather, except when it's hot and humid in the middle of the summer. We're starting to get to that season. These will build much bigger and eventually create thunderstorms when it's humid. The stratus clouds are the ones that really just mean a fairly unsettled day, and besides thunderstorms, give you all the different kinds of precipitation. And then the cirrus clouds are the high, thin, wispy clouds that usually indicate the day you're in is going to be nice, but the next day it's going to rain or snow. All of these things are what we learned back in school to try to become a meteorologist. Our education is 4 to 5 years of all of the basics about meteorology and then how to be on television and how not to be nervous on television. But there are thousands of meteorologist positions out there in the world that are not necessarily television. One of them is investigating the water cycle. We're in a different subject where we don't have everything totally figured out about meteorology. So while we are able to tell you a lot of things, like let's say about the water cycle and how it works, it is a really tricky thing to be able to jam a lot of these math equations into computers and try to tell us what's going to happen 4 or 5 days from now, which is really where we are in our weather business right now. I went to Linden State College. It's up in northeastern Vermont, probably about 2 hours from where you are. And from that location, I was able to find a job out of school in Iowa and have now been on television for almost 25 years. Iowa, Florida, Nashville, Tennessee, and have been here now at WMUR for the past 14 years. Some of the big storms we get here in New Hampshire, nor'easters give you that foot of snow, that big snow day that you get in January. Thunderstorms give us a lot of different things. The most damaging kind of weather we get here in New Hampshire is flooding. That's the one we look for more than anything else. You folks have a river going right through Conway that's one of those rivers that we follow very closely. Lightning is the tricky one. We cannot predict exactly where lightning's going to happen. So that is one that we're usually very focused on exactly when those thunderstorms are moving in. Hail can cause a lot of damage. The potential of tornadoes can cause a lot of damage. And obviously rainbows are very pretty and allow us to talk about the weather in a very nice fashion. We don't get a lot of tornadoes in New Hampshire, maybe about 1 a year. What we do see 10 times more than that are microbursts, where the wind comes straight out of the storm and then gets to the ground in all directions. We use weather instruments to figure out a lot about weather, so it is a lot of science and a lot of math doing what we do on a daily basis. This is a look at a set of weather instruments out at a local airport. The closest one to you folks is at the airport in Fryeburg, Maine. Here's how I do the weather on TV. Doesn't necessarily look like I'm standing in front of a blue or green wall. It is actually a colored screen, which can be blue, green, red, or brown. And it is not a 20-foot by 20-foot television screen, which would be really expensive. In the camera that I talked to you at home, we have a computer. And that computer, we tell it to look for the color of the wall and change it into the weather map. So I cannot wear the color of the weather map, or it's going to think that what I am wearing, that color of the wall, is the wall, and we'll change that into the weather map. So one of the interesting things about my job is because we don't have a script like the anchors do, we are not necessarily reading everything word for you on television, much like right now. I don't necessarily have a script. We stand up there for 2 or 3 minutes, and then we talk about our own maps and our own forecast in our own words, and in a way to be able to give you the information that you need on a daily basis. Best part of my job is the fact that the weather is always different every single day. It's never a boring moment here in the Weather Center. Even in the stretch that we're currently in right now as we record this for you with 7 or 8 days of really no rain chances, it's still a challenge every morning to try to figure out what the temperatures are going to do or if it's going to be windy or what the weekend looks like. There's always something out there as far as a challenge is concerned. If you have any questions about our profession or if it is something you're truly interested in, and most of us in meteorology, we have an interest from about your age on, and it becomes a hobby first. It's something we really decide later on that we can have as a job. You can always email us. Our email address is the word weather, and then the at symbol, and then WMUR.com. That will get to all of us. You can just address me or Haley. Haley is another one that answers a lot of questions about weather, and we're happy to answer them for you. Thank you so much, Conway, for allowing me to be part of your career day.